What up, YouTube? This is the Batcave Brewery Keezer Bar build that I did. First off, over here, controlling everything with this Inkbird temperature controller. This is how you make sure that the freezer actually cycles on and off and doesn't just freeze all of your beer. Right now, the temperature is obviously high. I keep this thing set to 44, but with the lid open, the temperature's gonna come up. I got the control switches that I set up here. One is for the light on the front of the display, and then this one is for the bat signal that casts up to the roof. Going inside this will fit three kegs. I've got two in here right now. Down here, that is just a rubber or a plastic mesh that I cut to lift these kegs off of the actual bottom. It makes it so that whenever it starts to freeze down there, because you always get condensation in these Keezer bars that freeze, that these don't actually get frozen to the bottom as easily, allowing me to remove them when they go empty and everything like that. Then way down there at the bottom is the plug, that's the drain plug, and I'll show you on the outside the system that I have for draining this thing whenever I thaw it out. This is where the freezer stops. This is the wood collar that I built. I put this foam seal here on the top just to make sure that there was a good solid seal with the freezer top. And then you'll see in the build video, all you really do is make a covering for this and connect it, you know, screw it right on there to the freezer top. Pop the hinges off of the regular freezer and use those as a support for this. That just makes it easy to line everything up on this door so that it opens and closes like normal. Put these chains in here to reinforce it, because with the travertine towel top that I did do in the collar and then the coffin top and all of that stuff, there's a lot of extra weight on this. And I didn't want to trust it just to those hinges, because those hinges are just designed to hold this lid up. And the last thing I want is for this to snap off. So these chains just reinforce it and make sure the load is on the chains themselves and not on the hinges when this thing is open, because it is back heavy because of that. Big old CO2. I got sick of using little 5 gallons, and it's just way more cost effective to use the big boy. The main manifold here. And I split this, and I'll show you coming around the back why I split this. This line here runs to the actual three-way manifold that controls the pressure to the three kegs that are in here. This is the control that just controls the main pressure, which I normally keep around 25 PSI, a little over 25 PSI, because when I force carbonate it at 25, I crank the beer up to 25 and let it sit under pressure at 25 until it gets to the carbonation level that I like, and then I dial it back to the serving pressure. I got a drain line that comes from the drip pan, and that just makes it so that all the pour off beer, rinse water and everything like that has a place to go. And then I ran that down into a removable just plastic bin, that when that fills up with gunk, I can pull it out and dump it. The nice thing about that is it doesn't really get stank in here because it's refrigerated. So if you think, you know, it is beer, it's sour, it's dripped beer, stuff like that, yeah, but it's under refrigeration. So it really is gonna be stale. I mean, obviously you don't wanna drink it, but it's not like you just have beer sitting out where it's gonna start getting growth on it, which is nasty, because it's all refrigerated in here. The three-way manifold that I have here, each one of these has its own cutoff valve and its own control forward pressure. I've only got two of these things on right now because I only have two kegs in here. And then I labeled them for ease of purpose, 1, 2, and 3. So I knew what cage I was hooking to for the taps. All those lines go up through this collar. Down in here, you could probably get a smidgen picture of all the electrical that I ran. You'll see that in the build video. It's all tucked into this dead space here to keep it out of the way. The thermometer in here, just double check the temperature that I have. This is the temperature probe that runs to the Inkbird controller. You want to make sure that this isn't touching anything. You'll see I have this coming in through the wall here and just draped. You want this to hang loose in the air. If it touches a wall or if it touches a keg or a line or something like that, it's not gonna give you an accurate reading on the actual temperature that's in here. This is a PC fan, really quiet, low voltage, and this just runs constantly to blow air up the one side of the coffin top and then out the other side. This is that extra line you saw in there running 25 PSI externally, so I can easily put this on the top, crank this open, push in CO2, burp the keg, get to get all the oxygen out, and then put it under pressure with CO2 so the beer doesn't have oxygen sitting on it. This is a water pump. I just use this to make it easier. This is connected to the back of the drain line that you saw on the bottom of that of the freezer, so that when I do thaw it out, I pull that plug that's inside there. All the water comes in here, I kick this pump on, and I just use it to pump the water out whenever I do defrost it. This freezer is in here backwards, and the reason for that is to have access to the drain line and to have access to this control panel up here, just in case you ever needed to, because if you had a defrost cycle built into one of these, then you could actually set it to defrost. And there's really no need for the freezer to be facing forward because you're not looking at it anyway. The backside here, you'll see where the hinges are connected into the collar that I put on top. This board here, all this does is screw to tighten the keyser bar itself to the frame. Without this, this actual unit will, you know, it's not really attached. It's just sitting on OSB. It would slide around in here and it would make it so that when you lift up this collar, it doesn't come back down exactly where it should be. So I put this extra brace in here to connect and tighten the keyser bar itself to the frame that I built. One thing I will show you while I got you out here is this was pertinent and very difficult to do. This comes off. This is very, very snug. And this is all insulated foam. The only reason I made that removable was so that I would have access to the actual lines to replace my beer lines. If I need to replace these taps, I have access to the back of the taps. If I want to, I can change the colors of the LED that cast down on the chalkboard on the front. And this has moved out of place. You can see down in there, that's the fan. It's blowing up, pushes the air over, and then back down. But it's making sure that the cool air is coming up here to all these taps to keep them cool. This is just a container. It's a decorative box that the keyser freezer sits into to make it look nice. You could just build a keyser bar with the freezer and the top and it will function as it should. But as a lot of you guys in these videos and stuff see, it's a easy way to make this look nice. To talk through what I've got going on the top here, this is some travertine tile that I've cut in just a cool pattern because it looks nice. And I had some extra from a previous project. This is the drip pan that you see the line run down to. This piece, this middle piece does come out. It's sticking right now because I need to clean it. But this does come out. Chalkboard backing so that I can put the beers that I have on tap there. I got three of these Perlick adjustable flow ones. Because I like different style beers and I like to run these at different PSIs and carbonation levels, you really need these adjustable ones in order to match the serving pressure to make sure your beer pours right. Another benefit to using these adjustable flow ones is when you're carbonating, you can crank this way down so you can get a good pour even though it's under 25 PSI. To figure out when I want to stop carbonating it. This is just, you know, the regular chalkboard paint up here to label these, that those need to be cleaned off, and these three taps that I made by hand. This is the bat signal. This was a USB powered light, a PVC tube, and then a delicately cut out bat symbol. This thing was a lot of fun to build. If you guys want to see how this whole thing was built start to finish in detail, I've got that playlist linked in the description. Hit me up in the comments with any keyser builds you guys have done, any customizations, and thanks for watching.